Okey-dokey. So we're pushing on here. This is our second mini lecture in week one on day two. And we're going to do a introduction to our basic sentence types. So here we go. Reviewing sentences. Simple, compound, and complex. Okay, so the very first type of sentence that we will be working with are simple sentences. And simple sentences will always have one main noun that is acting as the subject, and that will come right at the beginning of the sentence. They'll also have one main verb, which sometimes we also call the predicate. So simple sentences need a subject and a predicate. In order for a sentence to be grammatically correct in English, it needs a subject and a predicate. So here's an example. The girls ran to the forest. So again, we have our subject noun in blue, girls, a plural noun, more than one. And then we have our verb in red. This is also the main action in the sentence. And the predicate would actually include everything that comes after the subject. So the predicate, the entire predicate would be ran to the forest. Simple, easy, short. And we use these types of sentences for impact. Okay, so the second type of sentences I want to talk about today are what we call compound sentences. Compound sentences have at least two main nouns or two subjects. They have at least two verbs or predicates. And these two clauses are joined by the coordinating conjunctions. So yesterday we looked at the basic types of parts of speech, and one of I actually got an email from a student saying, hey, you talked about everything but you didn't talk about conjunctions, and that was done on purpose because conjunctions are linking words. They're words that join ideas together, and so they are often used to join clauses together. So in this type of sentence, a compound sentence, we would have two main clauses that are equal and they're joined by a coordinating conjunction. So we use the little memory device here, fanboys, to help us remember the coordinating conjunctions for, and, nor, but, or, yet, so. Those are used to join sentences or to join clauses together that are equal and are complete. So let's take a look here. The nurses rushed to save the man, but it was too late. So we have our first subject noun, which is nurses. Then we have our first verb, which is rushed. And now what about this little chunk of language here, to save? What is to save? Does anybody know from what we've learned so far? What would we call this? Okay, good. If you said infinitive verb, you're correct. So remember, sometimes verbs are complex. Sometimes there's more than one part to a verb, and often we'll have the infinitive form coming directly after the main verb. So rushed is the main verb, and to save is the infinitive form, or an infinitive verb. That's also part of the predicate here. Then we have comma, but. So this section here, the nurses rushed to save the man. Actually, that is a complete simple sentence by itself. So we could put a period there and end it. It's a complete idea. It has a subject. It has a verb. There's nothing wrong with it. But we want to add a new idea. So in order to connect the new idea, we use our compound sentence strategy, which is comma plus fanboys. Always when you have a compound sentence, you need that comma in the middle as well. That's very important. But it, okay, that's a pronoun. We just learned about pronouns today. Was too late. So was is the main verb here. And then too late is part of the predicate at the end of the sentence. So this is a compound sentence. And sometimes you'll actually see me write out a formula for this, which would be C1, comma, fanboys, C2. That's how we make kind of like almost a mathematical formula for compound sentences. Okay, now we're moving into the next type of sentence. These are what we call complex sentences. Now, the reason they are called complex is because, as you guessed it, they're a little bit more challenging, and there are actually two versions of this type of sentence. Now, complex sentences always have two clauses, just like compound sentences. Each clause will contain a subject noun and a main verb. And these clauses are joined by subordinating conjunctions. So there's the other type of conjunction. We've got coordinating conjunctions. They join ideas that are equal. And then we've got subordinating conjunctions. And subordinating conjunctions, this is when you want to join two ideas together where one idea is more important and the other idea is secondary or subordinate. So there are two possible structures to this, which I call, you can say that the head is the main idea and the tail is the secondary idea. So do we have the main idea coming first and then the secondary idea, or do we have the secondary idea, then a comma, and then the main idea? And how do you know? Well, it's very simple. The subordinating conjunction will always start the secondary idea. So let's look at some examples. Okay, so since they like ice cream, comma, they eat it daily. And now I call this a complex A. This is a complex A formula because we have the most common structure for complex sentences is when we have that subordinating conjunction at the beginning. But what we're telling the reader is that this idea is less important because it is started by the subordinate conjunction. So subordinate means secondary or less important. The main idea is actually the fact that these people, whoever they are eating ice cream every day, which is maybe probably not very good for their health, right? So that's the primary idea. So we call this version complex A. And then we've got they eat ice cream daily since they like it. So this is basically we've just flipped the ideas, the order of the ideas. And so now we're telling our reader, we're putting our primary idea first. We've got our subordinating conjunction in the middle, and then our secondary idea comes after it. Now, obviously, I've put the commas, the periods here on the outside, just because I wanted to include these names, because these two different patterns, I like to call this first one, where we have the subordinate idea at the beginning of the sentence, I call this complex A. Now, when we have the subordinate idea coming second in the sentence, I call this complex B. And that's just because the first structure, the complex A structure, is used more frequently in the English language. You'll see more complex sentences like this first example than you'll see like the second example. Now, also, I will be providing formulas for these, just like I mentioned for the just like I mentioned for the compound sentence, right? If we were to write a formula for this, the formula would be C1, that's clause one, comma, fanboys. Now notice you need the comma and you're going to pick your fanboys element and then we go C2. C just stands for clause, and a clause, it basically just means that there is at least a subject and a verb. You need a subject and a verb to make a complete simple sentence. Simple sentences can also be called clauses. So if we were to write down our formulas, this one would be subordinate conjunction C1, comma, C2. And we'll just make that a little bit smaller so that it'll all fit onto the same line here. How about that? Even a little bit smaller. Good. Now, also, if we wanted to make a formula for this one, maybe you can guess it by now. And I like to use these formulas. They're just a simple way for us to kind of keep things organized in our thoughts here. So then let's make our formula for this one. It'll be C1, subordinate conjunction. C2. And the key point here to recognize in complex A, you need that comma in the middle because of the structure, but in complex B, we do not put a comma in the middle because the subordinate conjunction is acting as the comma. Okay, it is the linking element. So here are the formulas for our complex sentences. So we've introduced basically four different types of sentences: simple, compound, complex A and complex B.